680's Chris McCusker joins us now. Chris, Bay Street, been pretty quiet today as our neighboring markets south of us are trading in their tickers for Turkey.
Yes, and saying it's pretty quiet is a bit of an underestimation. Very quiet, very low volume, and Bay Street essentially ended the day pretty much where it started. For those of you keeping track at home, now year to date, it's off by about 7%. Couple stocks of note, Bombardier higher for a fourth day. Shares in Cineplex actually hit a seven-year low, finished a tiny bit higher. Marijuana stocks finished in the red. And Finning International saw a nice move to the upside, sort of on the back of that federal fiscal update that we had yesterday, one analyst suggesting that this company is going to benefit from those tax breaks. Now, as far as U.S. markets go, we've got a half day tomorrow, though expectations pretty low. I'm thinking most of the American investors kind of checked out already.
Probably, watching football.
Yeah.
Oil continues to fall, almost down to a one-year low. So how's that affecting things north of the border?
Yeah, in short, it's not good. The price for oil today traded electronically. It was down again, so it's still hovering around this one-year low. We did have Canadian crude in the spotlight. The discount, a little under $40. That is the narrowest spread since late September. And the federal fiscal update yesterday offered nothing to help clear this glut, which has been contributing to the collapse in the Canadian prices. In fact, the Canadian Association of Petroleum Producers says the oil industry didn't receive the same benefits as other sectors. Now, Prime Minister Justin Trudeau in Calgary today to face the music. He did acknowledge it's an issue, but didn't do much else. The Alberta finance minister has asked for increased capacity to ship oil by rail. Mm-hmm. No action has been taken, though. So I don't know what it's going to take, but something's got to be done. The price continues to hover at these near record lows. Yeah. That's no good for Alberta, and frankly, it's no good for Canada.
So it might be the busiest shopping day of the year with Black Friday just hours away. Are we expecting a lot of madness this year?
Well, this new survey, it's a Léger survey, and it shows that 40% of us plan to shop tomorrow, 35% on Boxing Day. So if this pans out, according to this survey, it would show Black Friday a little stronger than Boxing Day. This is according to this Léger survey done for the Retail Council of Canada. And there was one particular finding in here that I wanted to highlight. I spoke to the senior retail advisor, and I think we've got some audio on this.
One piece of data that jumped out at us from the survey was the percentage of Canadians who planned to spend or considered it important to buy from a retailer within Canada. That was 87%. In fact, one in three thought it was more important this year than last year. We didn't do the survey last year, but we asked them how it compared, how their thoughts about that compared to the prior year. And we did this survey in the last couple of weeks of October, so we attribute those strong numbers to, you know, during these negotiations around NAFTA, the USMCA, as it's now called, really brought home to Canadians the importance of these big picture economics have on their own communities.
So it seems that politics has entered the shopping mall. The survey also showed that the average spend is $675, and 60% intend to spend at least some of their present money on gift cards. Do you like getting gift cards?
You can get me a gift card. That's okay.
Okay, good to know.
Yes.
I like getting them.
I do too.
Yeah.
I do too, because you get to choose what you want, right?
Exactly. It's much easier.
Yeah. And, you know, Black Friday kicks off the holiday shopping season for a whole lot of people, but when's the best time to start shopping for a tree to put all those gifts under?
Well, and this is sort of an outline here. I don't know. Like, it's feeling pretty Christmassy outside today. It's not going to be that way on Saturday. So I am told that the first weekend of December is the most popular time to buy a Christmas tree. The second weekend of December is better if you want to avoid the crowds. Prices hit an all-time high, which is roughly $83. During the first week of December, and then at an all-time low of $34 in the week before Christmas, and that's, I'm told, right across the country. So
you know what time's the best time? December 6th, the BT Christmas tree sale right in our front yard of Young Dundas. $10 donation.
Oh, that's a perfect reminder. I like that. Yeah,
good. Get yours then.
Okay.
Okay, thanks, Chris.